This weather scope is sponsored by Cadillac. The great performers are always creating a higher standard.
This is Weather Scope.
Well, wintry weather is spilling across the northern and central Rockies and the northern plains as well. Much of the east kind of chilly. Good afternoon, I'm Mike Bono.
And I'm Bill Keneally, and I noticed on your map earlier my cut bank was missing a digit.
Uh-huh.
That's not good. Was that a single digit number I saw?
Oh yeah, they were running about zero at about 9 or 10 local time this morning.
All right, so at least it's positive, huh?
Well, so far.
Barely. But that cold air, it's going to sit there for a while, but I think gradually it's going to spill down. Denver, temperatures in the 20s today. We've had snow. However, the snow advisory has been lifted for the foothills area for the time being, at least.
Mm.
Let's take everybody back, Mike, to Beantown. No snow, just rain and plenty of it. We had about an inch of rainfall over the last 9 or 10 hours in Boston, officially at Logan Airport. And yeah, there's some wind out there. Temperatures struggling through the high 40s and people struggling to deal with the second in a series of rainy days. So we haven't had very much luck the last few weekends up here. I guess we're kind of balancing it all out after that tremendous summer we had. If you remember June, July, and August, a lot of sunny weekends. So I guess time is the great equalizer up the coast. And we have a big area of low pressure out here spinning. Let's take you on in. By the way, the southeast in good shape. We'll have details on that in greater depth momentarily. First up, though, in New England, the big player is southeast of Montauk Point on the island, and that is a great big area of low pressure, and really it's stacked vertically, so the surface low is directly beneath that upper level low pressure area, and there's nothing to boot the upper low out right now. It's all cut off from the mainstream, so it's going to take a little doing to boot it through. I think it's going to be another probably 6 to 12 hours of chances of rain, at least, in Boston. New York City, the rain should diminish quite a bit, I think, by this evening. Still some lingering rainfall back as far as about Ithaca, New York, and down towards Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. And by the way, we've had quite a bit of flooding in western PA, but things are looking a little better. Still some lightning strikes out there getting towards the Bay of Fundy. And likewise, not too far from Nantucket. So if you're out there on the beaches around, say, Surfside or Sconset, take it easy next hour. And these may very well clip Cape Cod as we get into the early evening hours. Let's show you that radar scope now and see what's going on. Look at all the rain. We are awash in rain from East Portin, Maine, all the way to Sebago Lake. Steady rainfall here in Vermont, really from around Fort Ticonderoga, New York, to about Bellows Falls, Vermont, southward, down through the Berkshires, into western Mass, western Connecticut. This is all rain, and it's all coming right down the thruway now. So Albany, Kingston, Poughkeepsie, right on down into the tri-state getting the rain. The worst of it, though, appears to be in Brooklyn and also Monmouth County, New Jersey. But we're starting to dry out in Boston now. That's the good news. South of Boston, just some light rainfall. South of Scituate, it breaks up pretty much. Still the steady rain out the Mass Pike. And again, a lot of wetness down 84 today from about Worcester, Mass, all the way down to where it meets up with 684 there in Westchester County. The city, the worst of it looks like in Brooklyn, lower New York Harbor. Western Jersey, some breaks, but then a little more rainfall into the Lehigh Valley in eastern PA. Southeast in pretty good shape today. A lot of sunshine. We'll take it. It's been a while. Birmingham, enjoy the 58. Likewise, Atlanta. Now, temperature is obviously a little cool. Average high, for instance, in Atlanta, still about 65 or so. And we're not going to make it. We'll be happy to get 60, I think. Check out Miami at 71 and only 65 now in Tampa, Florida. Had a couple of records down that way. As you folks awoke in West Palm Beach heading out to church, a little nippiness in the air down to 49. Even on the beach, Miami Beach tying a record low at 58. But alas, we have a sunny day to enjoy on the Gold Coast. A couple of clouds building up around Pinellas and Pasco County, but generally the Sun Coast living up to its namesake, and likewise Jacksonville to Pensacola looking nice and sunny in North Florida. A lot of clouds developing in Texas and Oklahoma. We had some rain earlier in the Dallas area. Now it looks like a couple of showers, maybe a couple of thunderstorms starting to pop south of Waco, Texas, in that general area, and more down around the coastal bend. Into Dallas proper, though, things a little quieter. But watch out from Waco all the way over to I-45 as well. There are a couple of storms starting to fire. And a quick look at the big picture. Some chilly rain, temperatures in the 30s in Des Moines, and barely 40 and some light rain as well around the KC Metro. Then we have a little phase change out here in Colorado. And for more on that, let's turn it back to Mike.
Well, parts of the West are seeing snow today, the result of a high pressure system in that region. And well, some of that snow has been heavy, and several inches in Colorado, and maybe some more on the way. Let's take a look at the western map right now, and you can see the white stuff certainly showing up. The ever-present white stuff in Colorado and back on into New Mexico. We've had up to 3, 4, 5 inches of snow in some of the foothills west of Denver, some direct reports out of Denver, and the Coal Creek Canyon, the place that got 50 inches of snow a couple of weeks ago, only had 5 today, so you could say this storm is 1/10 as bad. Denver's had 2, but some of that snow has been developing in the Sangre de Cristo Range, even the high plains of southern Colorado and northeast New Mexico, and the San Juans have gotten a shot too, and some of those ski resorts there. But along the divide and off to the west, we're getting a much calmer situation, albeit a little windy, 40 mile an hour gusts so far.